Watch it all fall out. Pull it up, pull it up. That's how we ball out. Throw it up, throw it up. Watch it all.
My name is Emery Johnson. I'm 25 years old. I'm from the south side of Chicago, beyond popular belief, but yeah, I can be rested as well. And a little bit about me, I have a Bachelor's of Science in Marketing. I'm versatile, and I'm single.
But first, a bloody year in Chicago, and residents, police, and community leaders are asking why the violence is getting worse instead of better. It is already the deadliest year in more than two decades. The killings were mostly clustered in the city's south and west sides.
If I was to describe Chicago, particularly the south side, which I'm most familiar with, I would say that it's almost like any other hood. It's gonna be a hood no matter where you go, and it's all bad. But I do think that crime in Chicago is kind of centralized on the south side. You know, and there is crime on the west side as well, but it seems to be more gun violence on the south side. I remember even taking my friend Dejanay on her birthday to Chicago, because that was just like, what, maybe 2013 or 14, and I said, I don't go to the trains a lot, because walking down 60th and King Drive up to 63rd and King Drive, if you're from where I'm from, you know that it's a mess over there, going towards Parkway Gardens projects. And I was walking up the street, we literally go two blocks, and somebody starts shooting in broad daylight. So I'm running down the street, and then her big ass trying to run too, and I'm just like, oh my God, I'm gonna leave my friends with death. But I didn't, and so we got back to my house, and we just ordered an Uber. You know, it's just things like that, that it's just unsafe and unstable to live in. The gun violence and crime rate has really grown even more.
Second night of angry protests on the streets of Chicago ended in four arrests. Hundreds of people took over the streets of downtown Chicago late Wednesday, marching to decry the killing by a police officer last year of 17-year-old Laquan McDonald. The officer, no longer on the force, now charged with first-degree murder. But the mood here, the mood between police and these demonstrators, as we're about to show you, it's getting more intense.
That's really sad. Children die, all types of things. But the things I do love about Chicago is the food. I love mild sauce. I love Italian beefs. I love Italian Fiesta pizza. I love Garrett's popcorn. I can go down a list of things that you would love to have in your mouth. If I was to describe myself, I would say, first, I am black. Then I am gay, and then I am a man. Man comes last for me because I feel like I'm on the gender non-conforming scale, so I kind of gravitate to whatever I'm feeling like in a day. I can feel more like I'm a woman or more femme or whatever that is, and other days I can be more laid back, masculine, or macho. As far as gay, that comes second for me because as much oppression as they do experience, and which is a lot, especially as a gay black man, that is intersectional. It comes up a lot, but black to me always comes first. It's the first thing you see when you see me. You cannot separate black from me when you see me from a distance. You have to get close to me, maybe, to know that I'm gay, depending on what I'm wearing. And that's just how it comes. My oppression starts with being black, so that's why I say that. Okay, so I made a post on Facebook about people I was cool with in 2009 does not necessarily mean that I'm cool with you in 2016 or 2017. I say that because relationships change. Why are you writing me trying to pick up where we left off? You know, I'm not for that shit. I think people stop fucking with each other for a reason. If we have not talked in this long, why do you think I'm gonna talk to you today? And I don't feel like your intentions are good. I think that you only want to be in my circle because you may have saw something that you liked, or you might think I'm popular, or you might think I have some money, and now this is your chance to initiate where you left, you know, pick up where you left off, but I'm not welcoming that. You are not welcome in, the door is locked, and bitch, you never had the key to come back in the first place. For me, I believe in people being genuine. So, like I said, if we have not talked in that long, it's no reason for us to be associated.
Thank you. Goodbye now. Goodbye. Goodbye. Thank you. Goodbye.
If I was to define good sex and bad sex, this is easily can be a raunchy question, but I actually am a romantic type in the bed when it comes to dating. So good sex while dating is, because it's a difference, bitch. It's a difference. Good sex while dating is a very intimate, highly intimate level, where we get to a level where we are so spiritually connected that time escapes. We can look at each other's eyes. You don't even realize how long y'all kissing. Touching your body is enough to get me erect. Any erogenous area on my body, if I love you, good sex is you touch my body, I feel every part of you. And of course the sex comes. I do believe in a mixture of slow and fast. You know, surprise me. And as far as like casual sex, I think that's different. Good sex on a casual sex level, I'm not looking for any romance. Let's get it in, let's get to the point. So good sex in that level is you meet someone's size requirements in the front and back. Size requirements for me, this is so terrible. You know, two hands. As far as the back, I actually prefer a smaller waist. I prefer slim guys. If you are, but I do attract a lot of muscular guys, which is surprising. It's as much as they, you know, say online that I don't like skinny guys who don't work out in the gym. That's a whole bunch of bullshit, I promise you it is. But I can do a horse ass, you know, big thighs, whatever. I mean, it's fun to climb. Like big thighs, big legs, grab a saddle. You never seen something? You can grab a saddle. You just gotta know what you're doing. Being clean, smelling nice. I think that kind of sums it up. Even if you don't know what you're doing, if you got the right parts, you can make it into a magical situation.